Welcome back, nerds. Fino here with a latecomer's guide for the New Year's event. Sparrow's Inn Daily Report, records of the enma-tei's prosperity. Here you have to save Gordon Ramsay from insolvency by gathering materials and renovating the place. The big sticking point for the people watching this video is going to be the point system. Sparrow's Inn has a point ladder that locks event progression, but you don't get points just by doing free quests. Instead, you get a daily point income at 10 a.m. Pacific time. What dictates the specific number of points is guest satisfaction, which you increase by renovating beni-enma's inn. To do that, you farm requests for three types of wood materials, each improvement typically requiring two separate wood types. Event progression will therefore involve grinding requests to build all available improvements, waiting for daily point income to unlock the next story chunk via ladder reward, and repeating the process with a new set of improvements until you're done. Right off the bat, this means that you physically cannot finish the event in a single day, no matter how much AP you throw at it. You don't need the whole event duration, thankfully, but even if you plan to slack, it pays to front-load your grinding so you can at least accumulate some daily income. To help you along, I've got some quick tips to improve your farming. First of all, you should run a backline of event servants to improve your wood gain. For all-around bonuses, beni-enma gives +2, and certain event servants give +1, including Mash. Every other servant gives +1, but only to a single type of wood, depending on their class. Now that isn't to say you need to build your own farming teams around them. A lot of these aren't effective farmers, and trying to grind with them is a recipe for frustration and wasted command spells. The Shop CE Goddess of the Glittering Snow will give you a wood bonus, but also run your team cost quite high. Early on, you should only run Shop Currency CEs until you can get every copy. Clearing the shop is a low priority until you finish the main event, or at least unlock better nodes. Speaking of nodes, the three free quests early on each correspond to one kind of wood. They are Scottyable, though Lancelot teams will need to be creative with their skill usage to get enough refund against Berserker first waves. Once you get enough points to enter Phase 2, you should focus on repairing the Hot Springs in Phoenix Room, which will give you better free quests. Now, the Hot Springs are tricky because each node is gender-locked. The female baths are easier for people who can run Scotty at Atlanta, but slow if you can't. The male baths are a huge pain to farm, but let you run Waver in exchange. Scotty looping is obviously not possible, but a high skill, a high NP level Finn McCool can loop the node with double Waver and Fragment of 2004. The final set of nodes are relatively straightforward, so I wouldn't worry too much once you unlock them. Some of the story and side story battles are a bit obnoxious, so I've got a few pointers for them. The Hot Springs repair quest has a mandatory Dearmit support, who you should keep in the back row and plug suit in once the boss is near death. His attacks negate its infinite guts. The Jigoku Kitchen side quest has a mandatory formation, but can also be simplified with the plug suit to replace a frontliner with Gorgon. I'll also note that if you can keep Anne and Mary alive, they'll likely be at low health from brawling. This means their enmity noble phantasm is a viable option against the boss. As for the final boss, I'd recommend bringing an Invuln Pierce craft essence and some form of debuff cleanse. On a side note, the shop has two Tamamo-themed command codes that are both niche, but quite useful in those niches, giving a heal amp and stun immunity. Even if you botch the event, I'd recommend farming enough to get those. Oh, there's a challenge quest as well, but as per usual, I'll cover it in a separate video. And that's all, folks. Good luck, and remember to start sooner rather than later. If you wait too long, you can actually softlock this event, and that's no fun. That said, thanks for watching. Like if you enjoyed this video, subscribe for more, and come watch me on Twitch where I stream every weekend, Friday through Sunday, 3 p.m. Pacific time. This week, you may see some surprise streams where I try to pick up some missing servants on the daily banners, so keep an eye on my Twitter or Discord for relevant stream announcements. See you there.